Hello, everybody. It is 1:09 p.m. Central Time on Friday, November 11th, 2016. It's 11:11. Hope you guys are doing good. Just jumping on here really quick. Guys, last night about, I don't even know what time it was. I guess it was probably about 4, probably about 3 or 4 in the morning. I started getting messages from my moderators letting me know my live stream was off. And I mean, luckily I was awake. I was downstairs in the basement watching a bunch of social justice warrior videos, a bunch of people crying about Trump winning. And I was watching the protest, a bunch of idiots running around, you know, breaking things and freaking out because they don't like the outcome of a Democratic vote. Watching all those, man. So, you know, I got internet. I'm watching videos. I'm downstairs. And then ding, ding, my phone goes off and it's like, hey, live stream's down. And I'm like, what? And I go up and I come up and it's still running. It was still running. And I'm like, well, what do you mean it's down? It's still active. Like, what the hell? I go on to my thing and it's been turned off by YouTube. And they did it again. They shut me off. Again. Now get this, guys. I finally figured out why they shut me off. I think I understand why they shut me off last night. Okay? Last night, we had an earthquake show up in Colorado that they kept revising. They took it off the map, then they put it back on, then they took it off, and they put it back on. Now this is very, very interesting. This location in Colorado is very close to a spot, well, there's a volcano called Dotsero. All right, so now it's not next to Dotsero, but in Colorado, just to the north, we have a spot called Dotsero. But I believe this may be close to a fracking operation. And this may be why they shut off my live stream out of the blue, that they didn't want people seeing that because, first of all, we talked about Colorado just a day and a half ago. I said, look, Colorado's just to the west. That whole area is going to be moving around there again. We already had threes in Colorado. Well, get this. The spot in Colorado, in western Colorado, just to the north, is called Colbran. C-O-L-L-B-R-A-N. Now, the reason I know that is because I'd say, well, here, let me turn on a screen capture here so you guys can see what I'm looking at. This was 2 years ago, 3 years ago, 2 or 3 years ago, 2 years ago. A large earthquake or a series of earthquakes, larger, struck just to the north here. And you can see, I'll zoom in on it. We've got a whole bunch of frack wells up here in the mountains. All right, earthquakes started striking here. Then this large landslide took place. And now this part, this is crazy. As we get up to the northwest, you'll see more. But this very large landslide occurred that they tried to blame on a little lake up on top of this mountain up here. And it, as it turns out, it wasn't a lake that caused this landslide. It was like a 4 mile long flow. It looked like a lahar. And it was just sand, rock, pretty much just sand and rock, no water. No water. So you could see where the flow had happened and there was no water. Well, guys, it turns out that was a fracking operation that was under tremendous stress and pressure. And a couple of years ago, when an influx of pressure came in, the oil companies that own the fracking operations out there started to detect some kind of rumbling happen up on the mountain. And they dispatched a guy up to go check the wells. And the guy took another guy who worked there, and the other guy brought his young son, a teenager kid, with him, and all three of them went up the mountain to go check on the wells. Well, there's rumbling happening up there. Then all of a sudden, they get up there, and nobody knows what happened. Nobody knows what happened, but when they got up there, all of a sudden, the whole operation blew sky high and 4 miles of liquid sand blew out of the ground like a lahar, like a explosion. Now, the reason that happened is the frack wells there, some of them have been filled with liquid CO2, like what you'd put in your soda can, only trucks full of it. Okay, the reason they're putting liquid CO2 down into the ground, they call it CO2 sequestration to fight climate change. And they take these old oil wells that go down thousands and thousands of feet and dump liquid CO2 down into those shafts and cap it off and keep the CO2 in the ground. Well, that mixes with the liquid sand that's already down in there. And what happened, I believe, is an influx of pressure happened back then that came in, put pressure on the operation. It started to shake and rumble. They dispatched some guys up to the wells on the mountains to go check and see what's going on. They go up, open up the thing, and boom, it goes, the whole thing. Millions and millions of gallons of stored CO2, which then mixed with the liquid sand, and that explains why there was no water associated with this whole thing. Anyways, so when that happened, I came under serious attack from the professionals in Colorado, because I made a video talking about this, and I go, guys, you know, look, here's a CO2 sequestration operation. There's no lake there. There's no freaking river up there. What caused this? And they quickly shut up about it and tried to bury the news. All right. Well, now we have an earthquake striking there nearby. I need to go zoom in on the earthquake epicenter itself, see if there's any frack wells here. I don't see any. The ones that we see are to the north by a few miles, and we always look within, I would say, within 6-7 miles. And this might be a little bit further than that. There may be some more. Again, I'd have to inspect the area and see what's down to the south and around, but it's close enough. Certainly close enough. And the imagery date on this is what, let's see, 2014. So they could easily have come out here in the past couple of years since it's been blowing up out there with the fracking. And have done some more operations up here in the hills. We'll have to wait and see what the ultimate outcome on that is. Do we have any here? These are houses. I mean, this is what you'd have to do. You'd have to come through and do a manual search and try and find individual wells, because we're not going to get place marks provided to us by the government or by the oil companies, all right? So it's all human research firsthand by people like us if you want to find these operations. I had to find these myself when the landslide occurred and when the other stuff was going on. And I went around and looked, and I was like, wow, okay, you know, like, you think they would have this marked, or somebody would have, you know, a hiker would have walked up in there and seen pictures of it and been like, you know, what is this? And get pictures, but no, it's like scrubbed. So anyways, that's when my stream goes down right after that. I mean, yeah, it happened throughout the day, but then they kept revising it like they were studying it. And then that's when my stream went down. I don't know. But that being said, also Midwest activity picked up. West Coast activity picked up. Look at this. 3.4, geysers, California, Clear Lake. I mean, we're going up a whole nother notch. Excuse me. So going up a whole nother notch again. We went from twos to threes. Now we're at threes. This is the swarm still. This is still, we haven't seen the five off the coast yet. But take a look at it. 3.4 on the West Coast, followed by 3.3 in the Midwest. 3.4 on the West Coast, 3.3 in the Midwest. Boom, boom. Back and forth. Now you see it again. So just 0.1 loss of momentum. And I told you guys that would happen with whatever earthquake strikes on the West Coast. I told you that last night. I said, if a 5.0 earthquake strikes on the West Coast, look for a 4.9 to strike in the Midwest. A little bit of loss of momentum. Not much across that far of a distance. Check it out. It just goes from a 3.4 down to a 3.3 across that distance. And it's only a few hours time for it to get from the 3.4 over on the coast to the 3.3 in the Midwest at the fracking operations. By the way, this earthquake on the West Coast is happening at a geothermal pumping operation where humans have drilled down into the earth and they're injecting water to extract the steam. Well, the 3.3 struck over at the fracking operations where humans have drilled down into the earth again, and they're injecting water again, but in this case to extract natural gas, not steam. So both operations hit. It's obvious they're connected from the West Coast to the Midwest at this point. And this flies in the face of all modern day geology, and I mean all of it. They said it couldn't happen. that the plate's not connected like that, and that one 3.0 can't cause another 3.0 in the Midwest. That's what geologists said. Well, it's obvious. Here it is right in front of you. It happened today. That's the most recent set of earthquakes. Let me get the other ones off there. Boom. Okay? So, secondly, Central America. Look, Puerto Rico was hit. Puerto Rico was hit right on the coast with a 4.0, and now they're actually 4.1, and several locations showing actually more than that. But they went with 4.1. It was more like 4.5, 4.6. So, Puerto Rico, what can I say? I mean, you know, we warned Puerto Rico. There it is. Why was it a 4.6, 4.5? Well, the fours over to the west. I talked about that. Might lose a little bit of steam. I was more looking for a 5, but it's a half magnitude off. I'm a half magnitude off. But, you know, there it is. Puerto Rico hit, as expected. Now, down to the south. Check out South America, guys. We had activity pick up down in Peru. And you don't see it right now, but an earthquake did strike in the central portion of Ecuador. And I believe it was like a 4.2 or something. It wasn't that big of a deal. But look just to the south. Fives creeping right up to it. Yesterday we were talking about fours, right? Right? So yesterday we were talking about fours creeping down and up the coast. Now look what's occurring. Each halfway point has been hit. 5.1, 4.1 to the north. Oh, and by the way, take a look at it. South Sandwich Islands finally hit. So it skipped over the south tip and went down to our South Sandwich Islands point. So South Sandwich Islands finally getting hit. First round of movement. There is more coming. Be on watch again. It doesn't matter. There's not many people down there, but now that it's moving, it's going to get hit. I mean, it's going to get hit hard too. So other places around the West Pacific, check it out up in Alaska. We talked about it. We told everybody that we would see it. Compensation movement occurring to the north, similar in size. And I put a 5.2 magnitude watch on it. I said, look, we're seeing 5.2s go all the way around. 5.2 south of Australia. 5.2 in Western Indonesia, 5.1, 5.2 in Japan, 5.2 over here in South America, and now we have a 5.2 in Alaska. So it looks like that's what it's going to be. It looks like we're going to get those a round of 5.2s. If we're going to go with averages, we have 5.1s and 5.2s pretty much striking all around the plate at this point. That's a notch up from where we were last week. Last week it was fours. Last week it was fours going around the plate. Then we got this new round of deep earthquakes. The new round of deep earthquakes has led to fives spreading out. Now, secondly, in the West Pacific, I should say secondly, the middle points that we were talking about last night have been hit. So, the spot in western Papua New Guinea going into eastern Indonesia hit. Philippines hit. What else? Okay, that's it for the West Pacific. So Philippines and Papua New Guinea hit as expected. And that was the two middle points between our other two points that have all moved. Now, we've had a bunch of deep earthquakes. And I mean enough deep earthquakes that we should see a large earthquake develop off this above 7.0 in one of our silent zones here in the West Pacific. And there's only pretty much like one silent zone, maybe two silent zones right now in the West Pacific that really stand out to me right now. And that, of course, is between Japan and Taiwan, South Japan, and down here at the Solomon Islands, Solomon Sea. Every other location has been hit in the past 2 days. So our locations are narrowing down. We are whittling it down, like taking a piece of wood and whittling it down. We are getting it down to just a few spots where we're going to be able to see some large movement occur. When we see smaller earthquakes like this, it relieves some of the pressure. Ideally, we would want to see 5.2s go all the way around the plate and maybe go all the way around again. So, you know, a round of 5.2s hits the entire Pacific, whether it's the West Pacific or East Pacific, Central America, South America, and North America, that we would see that. And that would relieve that pressure, that it would balance itself out across the plate, but it wouldn't stop there. It would then go across North America. I mean, if we get a 5.2 on the West Coast, that would cause a near 5 in the Midwest. The pressure is going to fan out just like it did here in Central America too. Went over and caused a 4 point whatever at Puerto Rico. The pressure transfers to the east. Whether it goes across the U.S., whether it goes across Central America, or in South America's case, it tries to go down and around. So if we see 5.2s, and that's what we see all the way around the plate, it just means, really think about it, an area, well, let's see, it's about 12,000 miles across from Japan down to South America, let's say, 10,000 miles, and you go all the way around the plate, well, we're talking about an area, you know, if we go as the around the entire plate, we're looking at maybe like 100,000 miles cumulative between all the areas. If you were to follow them across the United States, Central America, South America, again, we're not talking about the circumference around the Earth. I'm talking about following all the lines and then adding in the distances across each plate. We're talking about a huge distance that's been moved at a 5.2 level. If you add that all together, that's going to equal one large earthquake. But we're looking in these spots in the West Pacific for an actual single large release as opposed to a plate-wide release all around the plate. Right now, that's what's happening. There's a plate-wide release happening all the way around the Pacific plate. So the middle points are the spots that are under tremendous stress. First of all, they haven't moved in 2 to 3 days with these deep earthquakes. And you would expect them to. So South Japan, you would expect that. And this is going to push over to Europe. Speaking of Europe, check it out. Okay, so the swarm in Italy has gone quiet. Gone quiet. Take a look at it, man. It feels good, man. Look, right? Topping out at 3.1. Yeah, all good, right? No. You're watching today, and it's going to go up. Most likely, you're going to get hit here with a slight increase. Why? Well, first of all, yesterday, the 4.8 down in Greece. Secondly, look at the swarm of twos backed up by fours going all the way over to Iran. Well, if you add up the fours with the swarm of twos, this already takes us to 4.3 going into tomorrow. So, you have a new round of pressure coming in from Iran, Turkey, and Greece. It's all twos across Turkey and Greece. That's good. If it was just the twos in Turkey and Greece, it would be just twos in Italy. Awesome, right? Cool. But it's a four back behind over in Iran, which means we have the potential to go back up. And it looks like it's starting to now. There was just a couple of earthquakes, and now it's starting to pick back up. You see it, right? Like we went several hours with just like three or four earthquakes. Now we have a 2.5. Let's see. Let's go back. In the past hour, 2 hours, we've had a 2.7, 2.5, and a 3.1. And that's starting to increase. So, one day, here we are, one day after the 4.8 in Greece, and your swarm is kind of quieting out a little bit. That, again, like I said, that's good. That's good. But the earthquake back behind here will kick it back up again. But, I mean, again, it's not a large earthquake. We're not looking for anything above a 5. We are looking for, since there's a 4.1 striking here, and we issued the warning last night for the 4.6. Is that what I issued? Maybe it was a 4.6 I issued for last night. So, again, you got a 4 back behind here. You have the 4.8 that hit in Greece yesterday. You add those two together, you're going to go back up in Italy. I mean, it is. That's okay, though. That's what we want to see. We want to see the swarm. If there's going to be a release, you have a choice. One powerful release with a larger earthquake or a swarm. Which would you like? That's your choice. So, if I would choose the swarm. I would choose the swarm of moderate earthquakes that might creep up into a 4, maybe, as opposed to watching it build and build and build and build and build and then, boom, larger earthquake in the 5 to 6 range. That's what's been causing all the damage in Italy in the past several weeks and months. It'll build and build and build and build down in Turkey and Greece and Iran, and then, boom, go right up through Italy. But seems like the pressure's coming into Italy now, and it's being relieved as soon as it comes in. So it's just like an instant transfer time almost between when these earthquakes are happening, maybe just a few hours turnaround, maybe a day. That's what it seems like. Last night, there were the 3.7s. 3.7 down in Iran. 3.7 in Turkey. 3.7 in Greece. 3.7 in Italy. It was like right across the entire Mideast into Mediterranean, 3.7s. Proof that they're related over just a few hours' time. Well, that's happening again right now. So, again, twos going across right now, letting us know new pressure. Look how the twos connect down to the four. The 4.2. If you draw a point going up from the 4.2 through the line on the 2.5 and through the line up here in Romania, it connects almost like an arrow. Almost like an arrow. If you follow the curvature of the Earth, it slightly bends. But if the Earth didn't curve, then you would have a perfect arrow pointing from the 4.2 up to Italy. Right? So, there we go. Have a plan. Be prepared just in case. We're watching the West Coast for a 5. We're watching for 4s to return back into Italy. We're watching for these deep earthquakes to lead to shallower, larger earthquakes. It's kind of go time right now. Don't let your guard down. I can tell you this. Excuse me. Again, guys, I'm recovering. I'm actually doing a lot better. My voice sounds better. I feel better. But I still got a cough. Anyways. So we're going to watch over the next couple days. We haven't, in my time doing this on YouTube, the last 7 years, let me show you the earthquakes here. This is one of the greatest deep earthquake events I've ever seen, if not the greatest. So the whole Pacific, except for the United States, has moved at a deep level down below. That alone should let you know. Something's going on down at below the plate right now. It will translate upwards and outwards, whatever's going on down there right now. It just seems to keep, every new deep earthquake that we're having, it's still letting us know something's going on down there. Once that starts to stop, it's going to translate upwards. Something is tumbling around down there. So maybe a piece of the plate broke off underneath. Who knows what is causing the deep earthquakes down in the asthenosphere? Again, is it a solid piece of the plate that's, broke off and floating around in the semi-melted magma? Is it a seismic shockwave traveling around the planet? Is it CERN? By the way, I find it highly ironic that we've got a mainstream media article coming out today addressing CERN earthquakes. And they're calling it a conspiracy theory, and they're referencing people online without giving them any name, talking about how it's a conspiracy theory and that CERN only gives off the magnetic field of an MRI, like at the hospital. That's not true. Every single magnet at CERN gives off the equivalent of an MRI. Now think about that. They're saying it just gives off one? No, this is like them trying to say a NEXRAD radar gives off 12 clothing irons worth of electricity. It's BS. A NEXRAD radar gives off 750,000 watts. It's 750 of your microwaves in your kitchen with their doors open, focused on a fine point, and shot out into the sky. Not 12 clothing irons. That's what the scientists will do. That's for the NEXRAD radar here in the States. Now, at CERN, it's every the magnets on there. Oh my God, trying even to explain this to people. For them to say CERN is equal to an MRI is the biggest load of horse crap I've ever read in my life. Let's just put it that way. And I'll debate this with anybody who wants to. I'll do it with both intellectual arms tied behind my back, blindfolded with a dartboard. My God. So, CERN earthquakes, could that be playing into it? You're damn right it could be. And the fact that they have to write a disinformation article on it today lets you know, and it was written today, 11/11, that they have gotten word that we are... Look, the deep earthquakes. We've been talking about this for the last few days. What could be caught, since the solar cycle is nothing, and the CME just grazed Earth, just missed Earth, what's causing all the deep earthquakes? Well, we've been supposing that man-made systems that are very powerful, dropping an insane amount of energy to ground, not a mosquito's worth. We're talking about the amount of energy it would take to shrink a mosquito down to an atom. Think about that. How much energy would it take to shrink a mosquito down to an atom? Oh, I don't know. Maybe 6.5 TeV? My God. So, that's disinformation. That's an article that's coming out. Why would they even feel the need to put out a disinformation article about CERN and earthquakes all of a sudden? Look, I mean, I'm a scientist. I'm into facts. The chances of them addressing CERN and earthquakes at a point where we're having the deepest earthquake event that I've ever seen in my life, and we are online talking about deep earthquakes possibly being caused by man-made systems, including CERN, and then all of a sudden they come out with an article talking about it, I'm sorry. I'm going to call BS on this and say what needs to be said. They only need to write a propaganda BS article on it as a cover story calling us conspiracy theorists is because CERN must be causing deep earthquakes then. That's the conclusion. You wouldn't comment on it unless you were somehow worried that it was going to lead back to you. You wouldn't try and dismiss it as a conspiracy theory when you're sending huge amounts of energy to ground. And also, when an article contains huge inaccuracies, like saying CERN's magnetic strength total for the whole complex is equal to an MRI. That is beyond foolishness. As a matter of fact, if I came out and said that kind of stuff on YouTube, you guys would like all laugh at me and call me weird and probably unsubscribe. You'd be like, damn, Dutch, that's kind of unscientific. I mean, you know, we wouldn't even call it unscientific. You would say it's just foolish. You would say, Dutch, could you please cite us the power requirements for an MRI? And you know what? We need to compare that to the power requirements at CERN and just see. You know what I mean? We need to test this BS because I'm not willing to accept conspiracy theorists as for another thing that I've been talking about. I've been called a conspiracy theorist too many times. I was called a conspiracy theorist for fracking earthquakes. I was called a conspiracy theorist for HARP. I was called a conspiracy theorist for weather modification when there's companies out there doing it. I was called a conspiracy theorist for earthquake forecasting. Now we're being called conspiracy theorists for saying that CERN could possibly be causing earthquakes. Possibly. Scientifically speaking, you can't tell me that it's not possible. I understand that you don't want to admit that it's happening, but to say it's not possible is unscientific. It is possible, certainly is. For many reasons, we could get into it. Like I said, I'll debate it with both hands, intellectual arms, tied behind my back, blindfolded, with no internet aid, no script or anything. While you can have any debater, you can have a team of you. I'll go up against a team of you. 5, 10, I'll take on 10 of you on CERN and earthquakes. And we'll do it on a live stream where I've got a 360 camera so you can see there's no one around me, there's no script in front of me, and like I said, I'll have a blindfold on, my hands tied behind my back so you know I'm not looking anything up and nobody's feeding me anything. And I'll just listen to the sound of your debating voices because I'm done with this conspiracy theorist crap. By the way, what kind of conspiracy would it be? A scientific one? A satanic one? Which way would we go with this since they dressed up in hooded robes a couple months ago as some kind of joke at CERN to cause disinformation and confuse people? Why did they do that? You know what I mean? Like, here we are. So, again, look, if it's a conspiracy theory, well, you know, some conspiracies are true, you know? We have to investigate now. Now that they're calling it a conspiracy theory, we need to find out and debunk whether or not it is or not, which I recommend everybody then go look into CERN and earthquakes. And what you can do is you can pull up the CERN schedule. Going back years, they've got it. I recommend you start in 2011 when the Japan megaquake happened and compare to when CERN is firing up and bringing their beams into alignment to when these megaquakes happen, like in Japan or in Ecuador or in South Japan again this past year. Or in Nepal. And you'll find out that CERN is going into alignment and bringing their beams into alignment at every single large earthquake that's happened over the past five, six years since they started bringing the beams into alignment for this, you know, to do the experiments. Yeah, it's just a big coincidence. Sure, it's just a conspiracy theory. Well, let's put it to the test. Let's do the scientific test and find out. Let's go compare the schedules to when the earthquake struck. Anybody down for it? Hey, CERN, you don't want to pick this fight. You'd be better off shutting your mouth and just letting us talk about it online without trying to smear us, because I'm done with this conspiracy theorist crap. You can tell I'm fired up. Because I'm, you know, look, I read that article and I said, you gotta be shitting me. Then I went over and found out Big Solar's talking about CERN today. Huh. Yeah. Big Solar says CERN can't cause earthquakes and that the only cause of earthquakes is the sun. Yeah. So, much love! Tanto Amore! Yeah! What's up, everybody? For real, man, you gotta fight for the truth. You gotta do what's right. And man, you gotta stand up against corruption. I hope there's one thing that you learn. Whether you're here in the States, whether you're overseas, that you gotta learn to stand up for what you believe in, okay? Only go with the facts. Don't go with the mainstream media, anything anymore. If the mainstream media calls it a conspiracy theory, then you know it's true. If someone comes in and tries to silence you for having your own opinion or something that's controversial, give them the bird. Okay? The days of this whole social justice, science controlled by a group, not anymore. And the days of labeling people conspiracy theorists? God, didn't we learn anything from this past election? Every conspiracy that was named out in this past election between Trump and Hillary, every single conspiracy turned out to be true. Every single one. There wasn't one that was false. There wasn't one. It's absolutely insane. So if we've learned anything, every time I was called a conspiracy theorist, whether it was fracking earthquakes, HARP, weather modification, earthquake forecasting, or now CERN, but we'll leave CERN out of it, every previous time that I was called a conspiracy theorist, it was then backed up and proved by scientific data and research and multiple experiments done in laboratories and in the field. So are they going to, again, conspiracy theorists. Hey, I'm going to end it right here. Mel Gibson's conspiracy theorist, the movie Conspiracy Theory. First of all, I've got a video favorited up by one of my subscribers. I think it's Edmund. In the movie Conspiracy Theory with Julia Roberts and Mel Gibson, the whole point of the movie is that Mel Gibson says the U.S. government has an earthquake weapon and that they're going to use it to target the president. That's the point of the conspiracy theory movie. How ironic is that? Okay, guys. So, much love. Ciao. See you guys later. I'll be back. If anything else goes down, look into everything. Always question everything. And don't accept the mainstream media on anything anymore. I mean, they prove themselves to be liars. I just can't believe it. Like, first of all, if you're going to write an article on CERN and earthquakes, wouldn't you contact some people? You know what I mean? Like, wouldn't you contact people who are doing the research on the CERN earthquakes and be like, hey, what do you guys say? Instead of just calling it a conspiracy theory. The fact that they would just call it a conspiracy theory means that someone at some point said, you got to write an article and call it this. And that to me is a sign. If you're in Italy, listen. There's a conspiracy right now afoot to try and hide CERN causing earthquakes. That is a real conspiracy. Not a JFK assassination, not Bigfoot and Loch Ness Monster, but CERN hiding science from the people. That their science, their magnets, their powerful microwave beams, and the klystrons that they're using to power it are causing earthquakes around the planet. Deep earthquakes that are causing large earthquakes and possibly might have already killed a lot of people. And that's them. That's their fault, maybe. And we can't discount it as being a conspiracy theory, because that's a way to deny science. And I'm not going to stand for it anymore. No more. They should have learned a lesson in the past couple days, guys, and I don't think they have. I really don't. Hey, scientists, you've got to learn a lesson that everybody else just learned. And you'll probably be out in the street butthurt and whining when it's all said and done. But that's okay, because we know that's what liars, freak jobs, and obfuscators do when they're called out and caught. They get butthurt, moan and whine, wail in the streets, and in this case, well, we got to send you packing. And you've gone all the way through science, not just in politics. We are talking about science here. Boy, oh boy. Bad time to pick CERN as a topic to ride on. I'd say, listen up, media. You want to get into this? I don't think you do. Not like, look, I went through this on HARP. I will not let this happen again. If it means me going out, guns blazing out here, InfoWars style, fine. That's fine. I will be the lead head on this and take the earthquake debate to the professionals with CERN. Since they brought it up. You can tell I'm bothered, man. That really pissed me off. Oh, all right, guys. Peace out. Much love. I'll be back.
I keep wondering about little details of your life. Are you carrying your wallet this morning?
I am carrying my wallet.
How much cash do you have in your wallet?
Probably none. I don't keep cash in a wallet, and I don't carry very much cash. You know, there's not very much reason to carry cash, I guess.